Rodolfina Ambas, Gildolice, ZP Kennedy. Mugel Am Admi Bosola, Mugeli Simbol San. Oil Swatir Santo Mulari, Amgele Goyan, Zaite Project Ahai. Te Ami Opus Kotai, Kun Amka Amgela Government Support Kuna. Goyan Kolso Naka Moon Ami Rostenje Atai. Goyan Double Track Naka Moon Ami Rostenje Atai, Bob Matai. मोले सोगली झाडां वाडां कातून उडयले सोगले प्रॉब्लेम कोता गोंया गोंयकारां ते आमी नाक मू बोऱ्या उलोवपाक गेल जाल्यार तो आमकां वता जेलींग आता एसोले आमकां गोवोरमेंट नाका गोंया आमकां गोवोरमेंट बरो जावो बरो गोवोरमेंट आमी न्यू हाडया आनी न्यू फेसा करया आनी दुसरे सुवातेर सांगतो म्हणल्यार भुरग्यां वाड्यां सारकी जॉब ना भुरगीं वाडे बेकार आहा यूथ तांकां हांव मुगेले झॅडपीचे कितें फाउंड्स येताय ते हांव तांकां हॅल्प कोतोलें आनी आमगेले झॅडपीच्या लुगारार इल्लें इल्लेंशें बारीक बारीकशें तांकां बिजनस कितें करूं लायतोलें आनी तें म्हाजें इल्लें इल्लें कोण वाडोवपाक लायतोलें अशें करून हांव तांकां हॅल्प कोतोलें तिसरे सुवातेर गार्बेज गार्बेज हिंगा थिंगा आमी गोंयकार उडोवन उडयताय तें म्हाका लायक जायना तें आमी सगळीं गार्बेज म्हयन्या वसूंक ना एक पाटी एक भुरग्या वाडवाड्यांनी धाडटली आनी ती सगळी गार्बेज एकठांय करून लायतली आनी ती गार्बेज ऑन हांव पंचायती हेल्पांक ती गार्बेज एक कडेन दवरून वेट गार्बेज आहा तेजी सारी करून लायतलें आनी ड्राय गार्बेज आहा तेजी रिसायकलींग करतलें आनी तिसरी सुवातेर म्हणल्यार ही ओल्ड आमगेली पोर्तुगेज टायमाची घरां आहाय ते घरांचे वाड्यांक कोण चोयना कांय कोण ना तांकां पावंड येता जायते पूण तो हो आमगेलो सरकार कांयच दिना हांव त्या सरकाराक झगडटलें आनी तें ही घरां सारकें करून हें घेतो ते कडे पावंड घेतलें आनी तें सगळें घरां सारकें करतलें आनी घरां बरें करतलें देव बरें करूं तुमकां सगळें आनी म्हगेलें सिंबॉल सान म्हाका आम आदमीचे सानीचे वोट मान निवळाय हाडचें सगळ्यांक काळजांत सांग मुगेले गोंयकार मुगेले ZP इलेक्शन हांव सगळे सपोर्ट करतले आनी म्हाका वोट मान हाडटले म्हूण हांव तुमकां पयलें देव बरें करूं वयता
In short, state your stand and the three-liner project.
You all know, you all are also part of GPN. I am also part of GPN. So, I am opposing all this. I am the part of it. So, I don't think I have to tell you all in details how. Because we all were fighting for this. But I was fighting not as a ZP candidate or a punch member. I am from Gidoli, now Goinkar. So I know how it is going to disrupt this. It's a destruction, so I oppose all this. And I think if I was showing them some letter in 2017, it's on record. That when we got a, me, I got a news that starting with a double tracking project and all. I did not know. I think nobody knew about this. That double tracking is for coal or some other thing. But we were fighting for overheating. And that was our priority. So what we thought, once they start with the double tracking, they may not do the overheating. So we were registering for the Gram Sabha. And then I was with her. And then after that, there was nothing official and there was no news as such. So, we did not do anything much further. But now it started, so I am also part of GPN, you all know about it. So,
okay, the next question. Can you tell us why are you contesting for the next elections? What are your motives or what are your ambitions?
A lot of things like I've been in the process. This is my second tenure. So I know what the ZP is, like how, what funds and what are the projects. Though the fund is not much, but for me, like whatever fund you are utilizing, it has to come from the people. So during this tenure, this is my second, so I do not see what the ZP should do. Come for the Gram Sabha, meet the people, ask their grievances, what is to be done in the village. This was not there. And all the time we were upset, like, why this is not there? Because it should come from the people. What I have wanted. Now in Bihar, I know what we need. Still, I need to talk to the villagers, their grievances, what they need. So that was the main thing, like I wanted to suggest to them. And then another thing, like all that time that name was there, Pitori constituency. None of us, nobody was from here as a candidate. So every time I was fighting, even I remember 2017 on the counting day, I was a counting agent. So the ex-sarpanch from Parwada, he was saying, I'll be the next MP. Then I started arguing with him, why every time from Parwada, why not from Pitori? Then when we were arguing, one of our villagers who was also present, and he asked me, do you want to contest? I said, no, I don't want to contest. But why not from Pitori? Or Sandar, anybody from our village? Because all this time, there was someone from Parwada. So we wanted someone from Chandan Vitoli. And there are a lot of things like. So what are the steps that you will take to help the unemployed youth in skill development? That's what I was just talking to Vipan the other day. As a fund member and as a salman, I was just from Vitoli or from the constituency? From the constituency, it's okay. That means ZP, I cannot promise the jobs and all that because that is not coming. But still, we can. We will, with the youth, we will find out a solution how we can do that. But as a fund, as a sarpanch, and for the last 10 years, we were the school, which is a government school. We were trying to start something every time. Rajan was there, along with him, we went to the concerned minister to start something there so that the youth get, not as a job as such in the government, but they can do something on their own. So that was a step, working on that. So eventually we will do something to get the self-employed, that is very important.
As ZP member, you can't do anything with the punch.
That I cannot promise or try to give false promises.
Correct, yeah.
That things are not going to. I don't want to give any false promises. That once I get elected as a ZP, I am trying for the employment. that I want. Self-employment, that we can work on that. But not the government jobs.
Yeah, you can request the future MLA or whoever. Minister, yes.
Next question. Are you happy with the current situation of garbage in our village? Okay. So, what steps would you propose, to keep the village a clean up and garbage free?
First of all, we have to educate the people. That is the main thing. Because we try to keep our surrounding clean, our property, and throw the garbage somewhere else.
Yes.
That is very important. And what we try to do, we try to blame the migrants. The tenants were staying. Because when I will talk to them, when we get complaints and all, what they say, no, the migrants are doing this, the tenants are doing this. Once the tenants, they question me, we are poor, we cannot afford diapers, we cannot afford the stuff, the packets which are being there in the line
in the
the garbage. So I really thought of that, and it is like, I'm not saying everybody is doing, but we have to educate ourselves not to throw, and we have to educate ourselves how to control that. We just cannot complain the garbage committee or someone who is responsible. First of all, we have to educate ourselves how we have to do it, because we are not, I mean, most of us are not staying in a flat. Or, yes. We have a.
So maybe if the panchayat can impose stricter rules or stricter fines to the violators, will that help?
Yeah, that will happen. For that we have to install the CCTV, someone will have to monitor. That's
so
why I
can
said
we it. Get the funds for that? Is that possible?
Yeah, that is possible. That is possible.
I feel the CCTV which is put over there right now is unoperational.
No, that's
it
what
is,
I'm saying.
And nobody is bothered.
Impose fine, and that's what I said in the beginning. We have to get ourselves educated first. How we have to deal with our garbage. We don't have, it's from our house. It's coming from our house. So we have to educate ourselves how we have to. The secondary is imposing fine and all that.
But first, this one. Even after going to the government, people don't seem to understand. They don't seem to listen. Yeah, they even after having gone to the government. Yeah, I know, because I remember Julio used to come for the Samudayas and all. And we used to educate the people. But it is people are responsible now.
Especially the youth, the children, they have been taught in the school not to go anywhere. I really appreciate. Sometimes even my daughter, she tells me like, when we go by car or in this on the chocolate hour, she before me throwing out, she will tell me not to throw, because now I got the habit, like put it in my pocket. So this is the. Actually, the punch member should be aware of this. He should take the responsibility. The board committee should take the it's not that only the panch member, actually it is a community, but at the same time the panchayat appoints the ward committee. So coming all together, we have to tell the panchayat that when this particular person comes to pay the tax, they should be aware that this person is having some kind of issue. So get the verification thing done and get the CC to the panchayat.
So if the panchayats don't listen to you, then what are you going to do?
The villagers are there, the ward committee is there, but we appoint the ward committee so that they can be helpful, they can help the panch. If that duty is not done, then we have to start with it.
Thank you. On behalf of the youth, I would like to wish you all the best for the upcoming 10th year.
Thank you so much.